Hello everyone, welcome to Team Revolution. In the last video, we have discussed about the history of quadcopter, definition of drone and quadcopter, and the types of drones. And in this video, we'll be learning about the various components used in quadcopter and its applications. So let's get started with the topic and deep dive into it. क्वाडकॉप्टर एसेंशियली एक फ्लाइंग डिवाइस है जिसमें फोर इलेक्ट्रिक रोटर्स एंड प्रोपेलर्स होते हैं उसे पावर देने के लिए। ये डिवाइसेस सर्विलेंस एंड फिल्मिंग एप्लीकेशन के लिए परफेक्ट होते हैं और हमारी जरूरतों के हिसाब से अलग अलग साइजेस में भी आते हैं। चारों रोटर्स एक अपलिफ्टिंग थ्रस्ट जनरेट करते हैं जिसकी वजह से क्वाडकॉप्टर को उड़ने में हेल्प मिलती है और जो वेट है डिवाइस का वो चारों रोटर्स में डिवाइड हो जाता है। इसमें जो डायगोनल रोटर्स हैं, यानी जो दो दो रोटर्स एक साथ जुड़े हुए होते हैं डायगोनली, उनमें से एक पेयर क्लॉकवाइज एंड दूसरा पेयर एंटी क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट करता है। क्वाडकॉप्टर को मोटर्स में पावर को वैरी करा के भी कंट्रोल किया जाता है। To make a quadcopter, the following components are required: 4 propellers, 4 brushless DC motors, a flight controller, 4 ESC that is electronic speed controllers, a LiPo battery with conductor, a frame, and a pair of receiver and transmitter. If we have a look at the block diagram of a quadcopter, तो हम यहाँ देख सकते हैं कि चारों मोटर्स चारों आर्म्स के एंड पे लगे हुए हैं और ये वहाँ दो रीजंस की वजह से हैं। फर्स्ट, टू गेन मैक्सिमम स्टेबिलिटी एंड सेकंड, टू गेन मैक्सिमम टॉर्क। टॉर्क की जरूरत तब पड़ती है जब हमें क्वाडकॉप्टर के डायरेक्शन को चेंज करना होता है और ये एंड्स पे थोड़ी सी एनर्जी को लगा के भी जनरेट किया जा सकता है। जैसे ही हम सेंटर के क्लोज आते हैं, आप देख सकते हैं कि हमने ESC प्लेस किया है। इसके बारे में हम इस वीडियो में और आगे अच्छे से जानेंगे। सेंटर में हमने फ्लाइट कंट्रोलर को बाकी की इक्विपमेंट्स जैसे बैटरी या पावर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन बोर्ड के साथ रखा हुआ है। नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट ऑल द टाइप्स ऑफ इक्विपमेंट्स इन डिटेल। द फर्स्ट वन इज फ्लाइट कंट्रोलर। फ्लाइट कंट्रोलर एयरक्राफ्ट का ब्रेन होता है। ये एक सर्किट बोर्ड है जिसपे बहुत सारे सेंसर्स लगे होते हैं और जो कि ड्रोन के मूवमेंट और यूजर कमांड्स को डिटेक्ट करते हैं। इस डेटा को यूज करके ये मोटर्स की स्पीड को इंस्ट्रक्शन के हिसाब से कंट्रोल करता है। इसका काम एयरक्राफ्ट को फ्लाइट के दौरान स्टेबलाइज करना होता है और पायलट मल्टी रोटर को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए फ्लाइट कंट्रोलर में कमांड डाल देता है जिसकी वजह से रोटर्स को कमांड के अकॉर्डिंगली मैनिपुलेट कर सकते हैं। Here are some examples of most commonly used flight controllers. KK2.1. A beginner can start his journey by using the KK board. APM Pro. This flight controller supports a wide variety of sensors. As we go down the list, the better flight controller we will get, but the price will also go up. DJI NASA MV2, Arducopter, CC3D, Cube, and NEES32. The next comes the propellers. One of the most critical parts of your drone is the propellers. These spinning blades are the wings to your craft, the very element that creates the airflow that lifts your machine into the air. Drone propellers come in many different shapes and sizes. They all serve the same overall purpose, but the flight characteristics of each can be dramatically different. The next one comes the brushless DC motors, that is the BLDC. Brushless DC motor is also referred to as an electronically commutated motor. There are no brushes on the rotor and commutation is performed electronically at certain rotor positions. A BLDC motor is a permanent magnet synchronous motor with a unique back EMF waveform that allows them to behave like a brushed DC motor. BLDC motor does not directly operate off a DC voltage source. However, the basic principle of operation is similar to a DC motor. A BLDC motor has a rotor with permanent magnets and a stator with windings. It is essentially a DC motor turned inside out. Brushes and commutators have been eliminated and the windings are connected to the control electronics. Control electronics replace the function of the commutator and energize the proper winding. Windings are invigorated in a pattern that rotates around the stator, and the energized stator windings lead the rotor magnet and switches just as the rotor aligns with the stator. Types of BLDC motors. First, NEMA frame BLDC motor. Second, gimbal brushless DC motor. Third, single pole BLDC motors. Fourth, outrunner BLDC motors. And fifth, Y versus delta windings on BLDC motor. The next ones are electronic speed controllers, that is ESC. Electronic speed controller electric circuit होते हैं जो कि electric motor की speed को control या regulate करते हैं. ये reversing of the motor and dynamic braking भी provide कर सकते हैं. Electronic speed controllers are an essential component of modern quadcopters that offer high power, high frequency, high resolution 3-phase AC and power to the motors in an extremely compact miniature package. These crafts depend entirely on the variable speed of the motors driving the propellers. Quadcopter ESCs usually can use a faster update rather than the standard 50 Hz signal used in most other radio control applications. A variety of ESC protocols beyond PWM are utilized for modern day multi-rotor, including one-shot 42, one-shot 125, multi-shot and D-shot. D-shot is a digital protocol that offers certain advantages over classical analog control, such as higher resolution, CRC checksums, and the lack of oscillator drifts. Modern day ESC protocols can communicate at speeds of 37.5 kHz or higher, with D-shot 2400 frame only taking 6.4 microseconds. Now let's talk about the LiPo battery. A lithium polymer battery, or more correctly, lithium ion polymer battery, abbreviated as LiPo, LiP, Li-poly, lithium poly, etc., is a rechargeable battery of lithium ion technology using a polymer electrolyte instead of a liquid electrolyte. High conductivity semi-solid polymers form this electrolyte. These batteries provide higher specific energy than other lithium battery types and are used in applications where weight is a critical feature, like mobile devices and radio control aircraft. Let's check the C rating on the LiPo battery. C rating एक बहुत ही important factor है जब भी आप कोई भी LiPo battery purchase करते हैं. C rating एक indicator है कि कितना continuous discharge rate है आपकी LiPo battery का. यह allow करता है users को quickly calculate करने के लिए maximum constant current जो कि draw हो सकता है LiPo pack से safely battery को बिना harm किए. For example, अगर आपके पास एक 3S 1000 mAh 20C LiPo pack है, तो इसका मतलब है कि उसमें से जो safe max current है, वो 10,000 mAh into 20C, that is 20 ampere draw सकता है. You might wonder, can I draw more amperage than the above figure? You could, but it's not recommended. Discharging a battery too quickly is bad for the health of the battery. It will raise the internal resistance faster than discharging within the battery's limit. What is a drone power supply board? जैसे कि इसके नाम में है, drone power supply board या फिर drone power distribution board, यानी कि PDB एक printed circuit board है जो कि light की battery से multi-rotor के बाकी के components में power को distribute करता है. PDB के common होने से पहले ये बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी था कि multi-rotor के हर एक component को वायर से जोड़ा जाए और इसमें जो अमाउंट ऑफ कॉपर एंड सोल्डरिंग जॉइंट्स थे केबल्स में इसे बहुत ज्यादा भारी बना देते थे जिसकी वजह से ये एक ऑक्टोपस का रिजेम्बलेंस देने लगता था. द नेक्स्ट वन इज द फ्रेम. अ ड्रोन फ्रेम इज लाइक अ सूट ऑफ आर्मर फॉर ऑल द सेंसिटिव इलेक्ट्रिकल कंपोनेंट्स दैट कंस्टिट्यूट अ क्वाडकॉप्टर. अ फ्रेम मस्ट बी एज ड्यूरेबल एंड रग्ड एज पॉसिबल while still accommodating the pilot's needs without hindering the flying experience and the necessary maintenance that will ensue. The majority of mini and micro frames are cut from a carbon fiber sheet. The popularity of carbon fiber as a frame material is due to its low weight and high strength. It is important to note that carbon fiber is an electrically conductive material. Here comes the drone frame style. There are many different frame styles related to the stances of the arms and the size and shape of the electronic carriages. The first one is TrueX. The TrueX is shaped as it sounds, an X geometry to which a rotor is mounted to each end of the arms. The perpendicular distance between the center of each motor is equal, therefore giving the quadcopter the same level of stability on all axes. The second one is YX. A YX has its arms splayed outwards to the side. The YX geometry is more common in freestyle frames because more central space is often required to mount an action camera and battery on top of the frame. The third one is StretchX. The StretchX is a rotated YX. The StretchX is favored by racers seeking more stability on the pitch axis, which can improve control when the quadcopter is racing at high speed. The fourth one is Dead Cat. Larger quadcopter designs typically favor the Dead Cat style. Its purpose is to remove the propellers from the sight of the onboard HD camera. This is achieved by increasing the perpendicular distance between the two frontal motors. The fifth one is H. The H style is another old style of quadcopter design. In an H quad, the arms are positioned at the front of a long bus style carriage. Recently, the H quad has lost favor due to its bulky size and awkward configuration. The sixth one is HX. The HX is a newer variant of the H. Instead of placing the arms at the tip and tail of the carriage, a true X, wide X or stretch X configuration is applied, most often wide or true X. The seventh one is Z. A Z quad uses two similar base plates mounted on top of each other to produce a step geometry between the front and rear motors. Mounting the motors on different planes improves the prop wash handling of the quadcopter, as less turbulent air is directed towards the rear motors during forwarding flight. The eighth one is Plus. A plus frame has the same footprint as an X frame that has been turned 45 degrees. A plus frame can be seen as advantageous in that each motor is responsible for rotational movement in only one axis, theoretically meaning more excellent control is possible. Although plus frames are more prone to breakage due to most impacts involving a forceful strike to the front arm only. The ninth one are vertical arms. Vertical arms rotate the arm's orientation to produce as small of a surface area as possible to minimize drag. Durability is not usually compromised as the arm may still maintain width. However, the frame's construction is often more complex than standard horizontal structures. The last ones are radio transmitter and radio receiver. एक रेडियो ट्रांसमीटर ऐसे एलिमेंट्स को कंसिस्ट करता है जो कि रेडियो वेव्स को जनरेट करते हैं, जिसमें यूजफुल इंफॉर्मेशन जैसे कि ऑडियो, वीडियो या डिजिटल डेटा होता है। रेडियो ट्रांसमीटर में ये कंपोनेंट्स यूज होते हैं: पावर सप्लाई, ऑसिलेटर, मॉड्यूलेटर, एम्पलीफायर एंड एंटेना। जो रेडियो रिसीवर होता है वो रेडियो ट्रांसमीटर का एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट होता है। ये एंटेना यूज करता है ताकि रेडियो वेव्स को कैप्चर कर सके, फिर वो उसे प्रोसेस करता है और सिर्फ उन्हीं वेव्स को वो चूज करता है जो कि डिजायर्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी पे वाइब्रेट करते हैं, और उसमें से ऑडियो सिग्नल्स, वीडियो सिग्नल्स या जो डेटा होता है उसे एक्सट्रैक्ट कर लेता है, फिर उसे एम्पलीफाई करता है और फिर स्पीकर पे प्ले कर देता है। मेन कंपोनेंट्स रेडियो रिसीवर के हैं एंटेना, आरएफ एम्पलीफायर, ट्यूनर, डिटेक्टर एंड ऑडियो एम्पलीफायर। Let's have a look at the drone applications. Defense organizations and tech-savvy consumers have used drone technology for quite some time. However, the benefits of this technology extend well beyond just these sectors. With the rising accessibility of drones, many of the most dangerous and high-paying jobs within the commercial sector are ripe for displacement by drone technology. The use cases for safe, cost-effective solutions range from data collection to delivery. As autonomy and collision avoidance technologies improve, so will drones' ability to perform increasingly complex tasks. Here are some applications of drones: geographical observation, security service, weather forecasting, entertainment, wildlife monitoring, precision agriculture, shipping and delivery, aerial photography. Aerial photography can be used for the following purposes: disease control, healthcare, agriculture, maritime, waste management, energy, mining, telecommunication, and internet. That's all for this video. Hope you like it. And do like, subscribe and share it as much as possible.